Hello everyone, I'm Koki from NarcissismMarkTech, and today we'll be taking a look at the Transcend TSCM42S and the TSCM80S. These are M.2 SATA 3 to USB converters, and the only difference here is the length. So right here we'll do a quick unboxing of the TSCM42S, which is essentially the shorter version of them both. The only difference here is just the length itself. So I'm not too sure where the USB 3.1 cable is, but it should be in the box itself, just that I have no idea where I misplaced it. And here are some screws. You will need it to install the SSD onto the PCB itself, and these are the two face plates which we will get into later. So underneath the box here we have a few of the documentations and brochure. Transcend always does this, but we're not gonna bother about it this time, so we just leave it aside for now. So let's take a look at the PCB itself. You can just pour it out like this, and you can see all of the components are on one side. So you have the M.2 slot on the right hand side here, and then you have the USB Type-C connector on the other side. So what you need to do now is to install the M.2 SSD, but we will take a quick look on the TSCM80S instead, because 80mm SSDs are much more common compared to 42mm SSDs. So we just take a look right here. They are actually the same thing, just different in length. And right here we have the screws, the two face plates, and also the golden nut thing, which we will get into later. We do have a M.2 NVMe SSD right here. We can fit it in, but it won't work at all. One way to differentiate between them both is to see the notch. As you can see here, NVMe M.2 SSDs have one notch, whereas SATA 3 has two. And the TSCM80S and 42S has only one notch. So you can fit in an M.2 NVMe SSD, but it will not detect. So here's how you install it. Take this golden piece with the thick side at the bottom, slot it into that little cutout on your SSD. There are three screws. One of them looks odd, so just use that screw and screw it in like this. After that, you can just slot in the entire PCB onto the aluminium housing itself. Take the faceplate and screw it in just like this. Be careful, as you will need the little hole there to point in a certain direction, which should be closest to the PCB itself, because that will be where your indicator LED will shine through. One interesting thing is that the TSCM42S and ATS does support UASP, which is to say you can transfer data back and forth at the same time. So right here we have some benchmarks. Again, this kind of performance will be depending on what SSD you use. The one we have here is using the Transcend MTS800. You get all of this performance in a very compact form factor while only weighing in at about 69 grams. The Transcend TSCM80S is priced at about 118 ringgit here on Lazada, but we cannot find anything on the 42S, which is quite understandable since the 42mm length SSDs are a bit obscure in the market. And I would say if you're going to upgrade your laptop's M.2 SSD, then might as well get one of these TSCM80S so you can upgrade your laptop's SSD to one that has a higher capacity while still using your old SSD as a USB drive. This is a very quick video, and if you want a full review, do click on the link at the top right corner here. And I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching everyone, and remember to eat some nasi lemak. Thank you.